there are communities that will both be inundated by coastal sea rise as well as Fraser River flooding. Basically every year they are at threat of flooding their entire communities. We're past the tipping point. And then what? Well, I think that's the unknown. We don't know. We need to do everything within our means to protect what little is left.
We need to do something because this is where we live and we've caused this problem. It's climate change. We have to respond.
Sea level rise is it's a slow moving car crash. So it's really important to protect these natural areas that provide habitat for waterfowl and wildlife, but also protect us.
The Lower Mainland is made up of about 22 communities or cities, and a portion of them south of the Fraser are in the Fraser River Delta. And those communities there are Surrey, Delta, Richmond, and parts of Vancouver, just the southern half of Vancouver. Those areas are very low-lying, they're at or below sea level. And just being so low and directly adjacent to the power of the Fraser River and the Pacific Ocean, it makes them vulnerable to wave action, wind, and winter storm surge events.
In my eyes, it's the most beautiful place to live. We've occupied here since the beginning of time as we know it. Being on the foreshore, having the accessibility to the shellfish and the salmon, as well as the mountains, which are relatively close by, to be able to hunt and gather in those. We've seen the climate has changed. Obviously, the sea level rise, but also the sea getting warmer. Hotter summers, milder winters, but more rain, which brings its own set of impacts. And for us, being on the foreshore, we're seeing the tides, we're seeing the change and the aggressiveness of the change.
The city of Surrey is located south of the Fraser, and then also it includes the Serpentine and Nicomeco rivers that are running through it. And then to the west, we also have the ocean. So it's kind of pinched by water all around. And so with increased precipitation and winter rain events, there's a lot of water for the city to deal with.
For Surrey, 20% of our land area is vulnerable to coastal flooding, and with sea level rise, that risk is going to be increasing. We have a lot of infrastructure that controls and manages flooding, so we have dikes, pump stations, ditches, flood walls, that type of thing. And so all of those systems become increasingly under stress from sea level rise.
With sea level rise, we're expecting about 50 centimeters by 2050, 100 centimeters by 2100, and then another 100 centimeters, so 2 meters by 2200. So as the waters rise, that low tide mark creeps up over time.
One thing that we're seeing a lot from our community members is a strong desire to use nature-based solutions. And so where you're mimicking a lot of the natural function of an ecosystem, to overcome the challenge of flood control while also improving the environment.
Saltwater marshes can help deal with sea level rise and coastal erosion by baffling wave energy. So it'll reduce the amplitude and the speed at which the wave hits the dike. And as a part of that, it'll actually capture sediments that have pollutants and trap that into the soil. So protect people, but also protect this beautiful space that's rich with wildlife and environment, that the reason that people live here.
We know and we understand the benefits that marine wetlands and salt marshes provide to communities. Storm buffering capacity, attenuating rainwater. We're looking at how can we protect people, but how can we also benefit nature?
We're going to build up the marshland in front of the dikes and collect evidence to show how much that reduces the height of the waves on the existing dike, and we can provide environmental enhancement.
Sea level rise is very complex and it affects many people over a long period of time. And because of that complexity, it really relies on partner organizations like cities, local governments, the province, not-for-profits like Ducks Unlimited and academic institutions to determine, you know, what is the problem, what are solutions, and how can we go for it.
We use science-based decision-making, and we're experts in conservation. And so we have a team of engineers and biologists that work together to manage water. It kind of situates us quite well to partner with the city to address sea level rise.
These things take time, and they take really that collaborative approach. We really rely on strong support from groups like Ducks Unlimited to help advance those discussions and adapt to the changes that are coming.
We have generations that we're looking out for. We're not just looking out for our children and possibly our grandchildren or our great-grandchildren, but we're looking out for our great-great-great-grandchildren.